Hello everyone, it's Net Sniffer here. Today we delve into one of the most fascinating subjects in biology, the secret of aging. What if I were to tell you that aging isn't just a matter of your body slowly wearing out over time, but that it could potentially be influenced by the length of your genes? Genes, as we know, carry our DNA. They determine many things about us, from the color of our eyes to our susceptibility to certain diseases. Now it turns out that they might also be involved in determining how we age. And this isn't just true for humans, it is true across several species. The scientists compared genes of different ages, from 30 to 49, 50 to 69, and then 70 and older. As early as middle age, they found measurable changes in gene activity according to gene length. There is a remarkable correlation between the length of our genes and aging according to new research from Northwestern University, Feinberg School of Medicine. Here's a bit of a biology refresher for you. The number of nucleotides in a gene determines its length. Each string of nucleotides is translated into an amino acid, which then forms a protein. In order to maintain homeostasis, a cell must have a balance between the number of small proteins and the number of large proteins. Imbalances can lead to problems in our bodies, and these imbalances between small and large proteins become more common as we age. In addition, researchers at Harvard Medical School have been studying the role of epigenetics in aging. Epigenetics refers to changes that affect the expression of our DNA without changing the DNA sequence itself. It turns out, these epigenetic changes could be a significant player in the aging process. I know what you're thinking, what has this got to do with anything? Well, this discovery opens up possibilities for slowing down or even reversing aging. Understanding these mechanisms could help scientists develop therapies to treat not just the symptoms, but aging itself. In the comments below, tell me how long do you think it will be before we can correct protein imbalances or alter gene sequences to stop aging altogether?